Hello everyone, this is Brian. Today, based on the suggestion I had last week, I thought maybe it would be nice to show you some of my records in my record collection. I'm sitting over here on the side. You can see I have this little microphone on my face. So hopefully you can hear me all right. And then I have the regular microphone here with the fluffy windscreen. So hopefully you can hear the sounds of some of the records. So this one might sound a little bit differently than some of my other videos, just because the microphone setup is a little bit different. This microphone seems like it has a little bit more static, but hopefully it isn't too distracting. Now, you can see about half the records here, and I have another cube this size that has more in it over here. So there's a lot of records. I have to admit, they're not all mine. Most of them actually are my dad's. He gave me a bunch of his records as a gift, and also his record player, so I have a way to play it. So the record player is old. It's from, I think, 1980, but it still works. And again, like always, I apologize for any traffic noises, like that guy on his Harley. So I'm not going to go through all the records, because that would take too long, but I just thought I would pull out a few that are records I like, and then if it's a record that I really, really like, I will talk about it more. Also, you know, I do have a record collection, but, you know, I do live in 2017, so I listen to most of my music on Spotify. So this is all music that I like, but by no means is it a complete collection. Definitely doesn't have a lot of the new music that I like to listen to, but it has a lot of the old music, so let's go through these. Oh, so this is a good start. This is definitely my dad's record. He is a big fan of 80s punk rock. Can hear the cord making some noise. I'll move it out of the way. 80s punk rock, and this is a band called X. The record's called Ain't Love Grand, and this one, actually, we used to have it in a frame, and it was hanging on the wall when I was growing up. I wonder if this has any of the songs that I know. Their big song is one called Los Angeles, which I don't think is on this record. I haven't listened to a whole lot of X other than, you know, what my dad would play growing up and stuff, but it's a pretty cool cover. It's got a serpent here. It's nice. So there's one. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Speaking of punk rock, this is The Clash. This is probably, this is one of their better records. This one's Rock the Casbah, which you may have heard. The Clash are an English punk band in the late 70s, early 80s, I think. Yeah, 1982, and this one is just like a single, but Rock the Casbah is a great song. If you've never heard it, definitely worth checking out. Maybe I should button my shirt here. Who am I? These are normally the things you should do before you start recording. Anyway, here we go. I have a few other Clash records that are in here. These aren't really in any order. Oh, this is another very famous record. This is U2. I never got that into U2. I don't know. It sort of skipped me, I think. I mean, I understand that they were big. This is, I think, a little bit earlier record of theirs. Yeah, you know, this one's got Sunday Bloody Sunday, New Year's Day. Some of the classics. I think at some point Brian Eno produced them, but I think this was before that. This was 1983, so. I think they have more of a raw sound here, more rock and roll, kind of less produced than some of the later stuff. This is a blanket I have on the floor, by the way. It's not normally here. I just thought I would put it for the video so the records had something to sit on, I guess. I'm not sure what my thought process was there, but I get to sit on it too. It's nice and soft. Okay, let's see what's next. These are funny, like Billy Idol. I don't even know why. Yeah, there you go. What a record cover, right? Am I in focus? I hope these records are showing up in focus. Anyway, Billy Idol. The hair. So 80s. It's really sort of funny. It looks like it's signed, but it's not. It's just printed on there. What else do we have in here? We've got a... Oh, Dead Kennedys. This one's in plastic. In a plastic cover. I think the ones in the plastic cover were all given to us by somebody, like one of my dad's friends. I like this where it says, picture censored, stay tuned for further details. I think that's great. Fresh fruit. For... Wait, I was getting confused with the rotting vegetables. Promise at some point I'll get to a record I can actually say something about. It's amazing how many of these I haven't even listened to. I know I should. Oh, here's REM too. I like REM. I do. This is early. This is really early REM. It has like a gargoyle on it. Listen to the texture of that paper. Definitely an older record. Let's see if I can find a date. October 1981. Oh, there you go. REM was from... Where are they from? Oh yeah, Athens. Athens, Georgia. Got a friend from Athens. She grew up there. I've heard it's actually a pretty cool town, but I've never been. Athens, Georgia, not Athens, Greece, although I haven't been there either. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Stevie. Grammy Award winning album. Look at that, it's got a sticker on it. This is Stevie Wonder, this is Imprevisions. Phenomenal record. This one has Higher Ground on it, which is just a great song. Yeah. What else is there to say? I used to love Stevie Wonder. Still listen to him sometimes. I think it's maybe, I'm not sure. Let me know what your thoughts are. I know some people my age who really don't like Stevie Wonder very much. I think he's kind of overrated. But, wow, I think he's phenomenal. I really do. He played at President Obama's inauguration. Which was also pretty cool. Alright, what else do we have here? A lot of records. I'm gonna skip ones I don't know much about. Does this have no, this is The Cars. They only did that one song that was in a commercial, so everybody knows it. This one is really funny. This is like, it's The Beatles, but it's not like one of their regular records. I have no idea what it is, to be honest, if it's like an anthology or something. But, yeah, it says, it's very, very shiny, first of all. It's like metallic, like a mirror. And it says, The Beatles Rock and Roll Music. And here they are. Paul, John, George, and Ringo. And this has a lot of the, like, you know, it's kind of falling apart, first of all. And I love all the, you know, when you look at these old records and the paper is, like, kind of yellow. Tapping on a record won't damage it, will it? I can't imagine so, unless I'm tapping directly on the surface. But I guess I should be a little bit careful. So this one's got, you know, Dizzy Miss Lizzy, Drive My Car. It must be like an anthology, because these are from, you know, Rubber Soul, The Night Before, Revolution. Yeah, it's all over the place. So, anyway. It also has, yeah, it has some of the early ones too, Twist and Shout, I Saw Her Standing There. Ah, some great songs. And what I love about it is that, what's interesting is that if you turn it around to the back, you actually see the back of their heads, and the sign is backwards, which is kind of fun. Yeah, there's some Beatles. So it's a great album, it's got a lot of their great songs on it, but it's kind of unusual. And then Rolling Stones here, Let It Bleed. It's got this like cake on the cover. So many of these are like iconic album covers. It's fun to even just have them lying around. Laying around. Yeah, it's got like a cake and a bike tire and I don't know what this, like film reel or tape. And this is like a gramophone with the record and that looks like a slice of pizza. It's just, I don't know, sort of unusual. So it's got Let It Bleed on it. You can't always get what you want, of course. This would be a good one to listen to. I always mean to listen to records, and I sort of forget to. Yeah, this would be a good one to crack out again. Alright, what else have we got here? I got more Rolling Stones, this one. Butler's Banquet. Very simple, kind of minimal cover. You know, people say that minimalism is like a new thing, but it's been around. It's been around for a while. The sort of script. Very hip. The design of this. It's got this just phenomenal picture inside. Look at this. Wow. Oh man, Mick Jagger is just like hanging out. Just like, this is like rock and roll. This is like the rock and roll royalty. Like, I love that the rock and roll stars, especially the British ones, kind of appropriated this sort of royal feast setting, you know, for their own kind of, you know, utilizing that imagery. So, I don't know. It's really very cool. Alright, what else have we got here? The Police. There you go. Sting. I forget who the drummer was, but the drummer was kind of well known. I think he was a jazz drummer. I don't know if there's any. There's nothing. There's nothing written on it. I guess you have to look on the record itself. I don't know. Anyway, oh yeah, they were written on the sleeve here. Oh, look at this. Can you read this? It says, all noises on this album played by the Police. That's pretty great. Yeah, that's pretty great. Position and the lighting and then the reflection in his glasses. It's actually a pretty cool photo. I think it even holds up by today's standards. I cannot figure out what is in focus, and I really apologize. Like, that's too close. Somewhere in here. There we go. That's the magic spot. Let's see if I can remember it. There you go, the Police. Yeah, they had some great. So yeah, what's on this record? Synchronicity, Walking in Your Footsteps. Oh, this has Every Breath You Take. It's the only one I really know. Yeah, they were very like new wavy, at least into my ear. You know, along with, I guess, like, The Cure and all that kind of stuff. But, I don't know, I do like The Police. Okay, let's see if Jefferson Airplane. Some of these are funny. Oh, yeah. Here you go. There's a record. MJ. So this is Off the Wall, produced by Quincy Jones. Right here. See? Produced by Quincy Jones. Ah, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Yeah. Off the Wall. Just a great record. It's a really good record. This and Thriller are, I mean, of course, both very famous. And, I mean, look at the font, the pink. I don't know who thought that was a good idea. I I guess at the time that was in this like Times New Roman pink, I don't know. And this, it's just, it's a little silly. And the handwritten, it's just funny. And it would not look like this if it came out today. This is a record I actually got recently. I bought it at a thrift store. It's another Beatles. This is Let It Be. It was the last record that they released, although they recorded Abbey Road later, and Abbey Road's a better album, to be honest. But this has some great ones. I love all the studio shots of Abbey Road. Abbey Road Studios inside. It always just, it really kind of helps you imagine what it was like to record. Yeah, and it has Across the Universe, Let It Be, Get Back, Long and Winding Road is. Anyway, so there is that. Let It Be. Those Beatles. I do like them Beatles. Oh man, so now we are getting, oh my god, look at this. Just look at this. I mean, how do you, who art directed this, you know? Anyway, we're getting into all the Deadhead stuff. Again, this is inherited by my father, who certainly liked him some Grateful Dead. I think they've got some great songs, but I've never got into them to the extent that I know a lot of people have. So I think I might, you know, there's plenty more where that came from. More. But this to me is great. This is beautiful. This is absolutely terrible. This should not exist. This is really nice. Just feels like, you know, feels like the Grateful Dead. Right? This on the back. It's like, you know, it's psychedelic. It has a point of view at least. Yeah. So there's that. Alright. Now this is a great record. Another classic. That is how you use pink, Michael Jackson. Rocket to Russia. All the Ramones covers look like this, but they're just, you know. Oh, it's just great, and the ripped jeans. Man, punk rock was such a cool thing. And, you know, still is there. It's got, you know, Rockaway Beach, which is not too far from where I'm sitting right now. It's got Ramona, Sheena is a punk rocker. Yeah, there's some great ones here. Teenage Lobotomy. Yeah. It's just goofy. Oh, the Ramones, they are all gone now. Alright, we are not even close to done. Look, more weird Grateful Dead. This is at least iconic, I guess, but still, I don't know. I guess it's kind of cool with the sunglasses, the big red eyes. We're not even close to done, so I should speed up. Ah, here we go. The Who. So clearly a lot of classic rock in my record collection, as you can see. I haven't actually listened to this particular album much. Who's next? I It doesn't seem to have any songs that I know that well. Oh, Baba O'Reilly, I know that. Yeah, I don't know. I like The Who. I think Tommy is probably their best record, as far as I know. But feel free to let me know if I'm wrong. The Pretenders. Funny, my dad has so much of The Pretenders. Like four records. There we go. Jimmy. What a guy. Jimi Hendrix, he's one of those. You can listen to music before Jimi Hendrix and listen to what guitars sounded like, and then listen to music after Jimi Hendrix and hear how different the guitars sound. I mean, talk about a guy who actually really contributed something to modern music. Oh, and speaking of people who contributed to modern music, The Doors. This is one of the weirder album covers. It has rounded edges. It's this like plasticky stuff here. And I think it must, you know, when you slide in and out these, maybe it's supposed to go this way with the yellow going in. That's what I'm guessing anyway. These sleeves always break on like all the sides. I think this yellow one wants to go in this way. That's what I'm guessing anyway. That looks better. I can see their faces. Anyway, Jim Morrison. I mean, look at those eyes. Seductive. See why he was so popular, and if you ever just see him perform, it's just electric. If you ever watch the videos, I mean, it's very 60s, right? Yeah. It's funny, but it's great. To me, this is like iconic, you know, the font. And the cover, I mean, this stands up well over time, unlike some of those other ones that we've seen. What else do we have? Van Halen. I've never been a big Van Halen guy. More of the Clash. We've got Sandinista. Now this is a phenomenal record. This is one of my favorite Clash records, other than maybe London Calling. But this is great. And then this is Combat Rock. This has, I believe this has Rock the Casbah on it as well. Doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Which he also has the single. So there you go. He liked the Clash. Alright. What else have we got? Here we go. Here we're branching out. Another one in a plastic. You know what? I want to say I bought this record. This is Miles Davis. And it has Herbie Hancock on keys, so I thought it would be good. And did I ever listen to it? Definitely not, because it's in plastic. There's Miles. Alright. Let's keep going. There's more REM. More The Who. This one. Who Are You? So, that's a famous track. I think that's a great, the food track. This is a great, like, set too, you know, backstage, not to be taken away on the chair. It's very, like, documentarian. With all the cables. All the plugs. Yeah. Interesting, they seem to have, like, this is like a UK plug adapter, and then this looks like a US plug, so that's kind of weird, so maybe it's not that documentary, maybe this is all a set, who knows. Alright, what else have we got? Another Beatles. Another like anthology. This is the early stuff. 1962 to 1966. It's like a double record. These guys. I think this one has it's got, yeah, you know, Love Me Do, Please Please Me, all early stuff. It goes through Help. You've Got to Hide Your Love Away. Drive My Car. So it looks like it goes up through, oh, Eleanor Rigby. You know what? It goes all the way through Revolver. Yeah. A lot of great songs. Beatles are one of those groups that is just always amazing how many good songs they wrote. I mean, most bands, you know, you can think of like one or two songs that they're known for. But the Beatles, they have like, I don't know, like 20 at least. I mean, so many good songs that everybody knows. Pretty amazing. More X. Ah, here we go. Here we go. This is also, I think, an anthology record. Maybe not. Yeah, yeah, it's got, you know, Surf and Safari, Surfer Girl. Surfer. Little Deuce Coupe. I love the Beach Boys. If you've ever seen that movie, Love and Mercy, about Brian Wilson, it's also one of my favorite movies of all time. I think it's just phenomenal. I love the Beach Boys. Classic. I don't have Pet Sounds on vinyl. That would be very cool, but I don't. Here we go, Fleetwood Mac. Oh god, these are so many. It's gonna take me forever to get through these. Although I think all the good ones are over here. These ones are, I don't like as much. Yeah, there's just like pink, there's some Pink Floyd over there. Oh, here we go. I was just talking about this record earlier. Here's Tommy by The Who. So this record I've definitely listened to. I saw the movie too. The movie was really weird. Super trippy, super 60s, you know. This is in one of my favorite movies, Almost Famous. She says, listen to Tommy while burning a candle and you will see your future. Burning candles, so there we go. Alright, the next one I was gonna get was this, Fleetwood Mac. It's another great, great record. This one has Rhiannon on it, Landslide. So 70s. Yeah, so this isn't doing much for me, but I do like the front. It feels kind of arty. It feels like it's a point of view. I feel like, you know, this feels like it could hold up today. And now here we are. I'm still not over the death of this man. Got two here. Ziggy. And Let's Dance. Which one's a better cover? Is it even a competition? This is like the worst, like, font stuff. And then this is like, you know, like literally a dance pattern thing. It's just the stupidest thing ever. He's wearing boxing gloves. I'm into the pink light. That's the only thing I like in this cover. This almost looks like Keith Haring or something. That's kind of cool. Anyway, you know, Let's Dance, of course, but man, what a record this is. Look at him. Great record. I listened to this a lot in the beginning of 2016 when he died. I'm in the phone booth, shirt open. Someday I'll stand in a phone booth like that. Do we even have phone booths anymore? Who knows? Oh, Sarah Vaughan. Sarah, well, it's always hard to pick with Sarah or Ella, but they're two of the greats for sure. This one's got Lullaby of Birdland, Scott April in Paris, Embraceable You, some great songs on here. I maybe haven't mentioned much on here, you know, I do like jazz music a lot. I have a few jazz records, not that many, but I do listen to jazz, and, you know, for a certain time of day. It's good music for when I'm trying to think. I feel like it helps your brain sort of make connections and put things together. More Jim Morrison. Oh, okay. We're about to run into some phenomenal records. Well, I skipped one. This is a new record. This one came out a couple years ago, and it's a great one. Do you know what this is? Some of y'all might actually know what this one is, since it's newer. This is Reflector. Came out, I think, maybe three years ago. It's Arcade Fire, and it's a double record. I got this for my birthday. I wouldn't have actually bought the record for myself, but the cut, first of all, it's so shiny and cool on the inside. Like, what a cool material. And it's got this crazy pattern. I mean, it's just absolutely beautiful. I mean, it's hard to know if it'll hold up. I mean, I think it looks phenomenal, but somebody might look at this and be like, oh, that looks so, you know, 2000, so hipster. Anyway, this has got some great songs. I listened to this record a lot when it first came out. It's a really great one. I saw the tour, too. They played, I got to see this concert, and it was so good. It's one of the best live concerts I've ever seen. I love Arcade Fire. And look at this, I forget what statue this is. I looked it up at some point. I think it's like Eurydice or something. It's one. It definitely has to do with one of the references on one of the tracks here, which is pretty cool. And and the actual sleeves here are. It's not Arcade Fire. It's the Reflectors, and you can see it really has a great look. I mean, it's sort of a retro with the shiny kind of infused into it. And you know, these cardboard sleeves are so much better than the old paper ones they used to use. And it's a beautiful record, and the labels look just look great. And they even have, you know, in true fashion, they have the actual lyrics written out, but they're written in sort of almost like an article form. like just paragraphs, but it's really nicely done. Everything about this record, you can really see the attention to detail, and it's just really nice. Okay, let's move onward. I think I only have a few more records I want to show today, but here's one. The name of this band is Talking Heads, and they are amazing. I love Talking Heads. I think David Byrne is just an absolute genius. And I've got a few Talking Heads records here. This one has a Psycho Killer on it. Building on Fire. It's a weird album cover. I mean, it's like way overwhelming. And the font is terrible, but I think it was intentional. He's such a perceptive person. I think he really knew exactly what he was doing with all of these choices, so who am I to question? Okay. The next one is one of my favorite records, another one of my favorite records of all time. And it's also in a sleeve, and this one has a very nice little note. It was a Christmas present from a good friend. And this record is Graceland. Oh, such a great Paul Simon record. I love Paul Simon, and this record is just so good. You listen to it now and it just, there's so many good songs on it. And definitely listened to this one a few times now, the actual record. It's always just a nice experience to hear something, you know, played on vinyl. I'm sure some of it is hype, but there is something about the physicality of the vinyl that just feels very human. You think of the needle just playing, just the physical way it works with the needle, reading these grooves in the vinyl and creating frequency that comes directly through the speaker with no kind of, there's no file, there's no digital file, there's no, I don't know, it just feels like a very honest way to reproduce sound, which of course that's why there's been this whole vinyl resurgence. Billie Holiday. This is a phenomenal record. And it's beautiful with the silhouette and the right aligned text. I mean, it's just a classic album cover. Oh, man. It's got some really, really, really great songs on here. I used to listen to this record. I remember it starting with In Their Eyes. This is definitely one I used to listen to as a kid. Billie Holiday is another great. I don't know if there'll ever be anyone else like her. More The Who. More Talking Heads. Fear of Music has got like a tire texture. I don't know. I also don't really love this, it doesn't do much for me. Oh, this is also produced by Brian Eno. Brian Eno and Talking Heads. Interesting. Okay. Alright, I don't think I'm gonna go through this other stack today. It's got some Pink Floyd, more Grateful Dead and stuff. but most of my favorites were in here. There's one more record, which is one of my favorite records of all time, that I'm going to get. And I have to stand up because it's actually, I have to get it because the record itself is on the record player right now. It's the last thing I listened to. So, sit down again. Alright. This, my friends, is a very faded. Very faded record. And if I will ever play a record out, it will be this one. This is Simon and Garfunkel's Bridge Over Troubled Water. Which is the best Simon and Garfunkel record. Although I really love Simon and Garfunkel, I always have. They're just classic 1960s, New York, Greenwich Village, folk band. This one has some really good ones. This one has... Okay, to be honest, Bridge Over Troubled Water, the song, is actually not one of my favorites. I usually skip it. Just because it's probably overplayed, but... has El Condor Pasa, Cecilia, but probably the best song on this record. It's a tie between two. Well, actually my second place is The Only Living Boy in New York, which is just so beautiful and has this choir that comes in. It's just like phenomenal. But probably the very best song has to be The Boxer. It's maybe their most well-known, one of their most well-known songs. And the lyrics are just absolutely poetry. They really are. Maybe I'll read them. I'll read them for you. So, I am just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still a man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway station, running scared, laying low, seeking out the poor quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know, asking only workmen's wages. I come looking for a job, but I get no offers. Just to come on from the whores on 7th Avenue. I do declare, there were times when I was so lonesome, I took some comfort there. Then I'm laying out my winter clothes and wishing I was gone, going home, where the New York City winters aren't bleeding me, leading me, going home. In the clearing stand a boxer and a fighter by his trade, and he carries the reminders of every glove that laid him down and cut him till he cried out, in his anger and his shame, I am leaving, but the fighter still remains. Oh, it's just so beautiful. It's such lush and vivid imagery, and, you know, it's a very, you know, this helped form how I thought of New York City before I'd even been here, you know, growing up. And it's just such an honest kind of portrayal of what it can feel like to live here in the darker times. Also, I've never really, like, looked at this before, but, like, what's going on here? See that? Which one? Where are we in focus? Somewhere in here. Do you see what's going on? Like, Paul Simon's, like, leaning into Art Garfunkel's back. It's very odd. That's funny. Anyway. Great song. One of my other favorite songs of theirs is a song called America, And that's another one that has just phenomenal lyrics. So, if you're into that sort of thing, you can check them out. There's some Neil Young here. There's some Bob Dylan. There's some more stuff. We Are the World, apparently. That record is in here. If you don't know what that is, then don't worry about it. Yeah, so you definitely get a slice. And it's interesting, for me, a lot of these records remind me of my childhood, because this is music I would listen to, because my parents, you know, would listen to it. And, you know, it's a lot of it is music that I like, and so I guess I can be thankful to my parents for having, or mostly my dad, for having some good taste in music. And yeah, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed. I think the records make some nice sounds, and it was sort of fun to go through it. This is fun for me, kind of a trip down memory lane to a certain extent. So yeah, maybe I'll do a part two someday. Let me know if you'd want me to go through this side of the records. I'd also be happy, well, I guess I have some books. I guess I could go do like a book collection, but I've actually gotten rid of a bunch of books recently, so it might not be all that interesting. And I did go through some books I liked in an earlier video about a year ago. Yeah, but other than that, that's this video. Thanks for sitting in the corner of my room here while I go through this, and I'm gonna put all these records back. So, sweet dreams, and good night.